Wait here. I'll be right back with your reward.
All right. Fair enough.
Look, never should have come here.
Oh, drat. Fools. You've made a great mistake. Ah, damn. Lydia. Alright. Where are the others? Lay down your arms. Ah, Lydia. Drat.
Think you can take me?
Yeah, I know I can. That fool. Stay down. I'll have him. Damn you. Leave her be. This is the last of them. No, sounds like others. Lydia? Huh? Ah, there you are. Good. Stay close. We have them cornered now.
Found you.
No way out. There could be others. Dead. But how? Strange. Perhaps another was here. Well, I believe that's all of them. That was a foul trick indeed. And I apologize for playing such a fool. But perhaps it was better it was us, if it was someone else. Some other kind stranger. Yeah, sure. I'll be quiet for now. It is a gold ingot. It'd be worth something to someone, surely. Fit it in there if I can. All right. Sturdy looking axe indeed. All right. Let's see. What are you hiding away? Surely this isn't yours. Well, you wouldn't mind parting with it then.
I've got your back.
I know. You've done well, Lydia. You're truly proving yourself to me. Not that I would doubt your prowess. You're a good fighter. We've been well outnumbered today, on both occasions. And I've come out on top. It's a sign of good things to come, surely. It's hardly even worth the time. Still, gold is gold. It makes Tamriel go round. I suppose this wasn't their camp originally. I suppose these weren't your clothes either. Some poor merchant. Probably be felled for that foul trick. I thought your friends looked somewhat unsavory. Should have known better. Lydia must be taking a moment. I'm sure she has her own things to collect. This blade has been sharp. Very sharp. He had a circlet in his bag. I'll pull it away for now. An orcish blade. Not bad. Bannercourt to safety, good. He's a smart horse. I'm going to need that. All right, yeah. It was almost as though you were going to give up as well. It would have been smarter. I can tell you now. Strong spear. Imagine that's the kind of weapon that would be useful against a dragon. If one can pierce it with a weapon. I only know that claws work. All right, it's you. Time to move away from that edge. You're dangerously close there. All right. Come on. There we are. Nice and easy. Just relax. Sorry for bringing you into this mess. Let's see. Lydia must be about somewhere. Just a moment. Fetch her. Where is she now? Ah. Good. All right, come on you. We need to get going. Find our way down, eh? Back on track. No more distractions. No more thieves. I hope at least I have a stead. Seems like we've reached a plateau of some kind. Levels out here. What is that? A wolf. Ah, good day. A storm cloak here. Doesn't surprise me. Suppose they must be more loyal to them here. Full patrol. Bastards. I'm sorry, brother. I won't leave you on the road here like this. Today. Come on. Tread too heavy. You do not have the means to offer you a proper burial. I'm sorry. This is the least I can do for you for now. If the rest of your patrol is nearby, no doubt they will return for you. I cannot take his shield. It would not be honorable. I will leave him rest. Rest where he is. I can't be far off now, surely. Another camp of some kind. There lies the mountain. Another fort of sorts across the way. Soldiers, they appear to be Imperials. And stick to our own business. I believe they have a prisoner. It is not our worry today. Eivastad. Eivazred. Eivazred. There are not so good of place names here. It is not my home. Surely we must be nearing our destination. The road seems clear for now. Red. What now? Soldiers or the wolf is gone. What in the name? It is not our fight. Sounds of that. It's close. Now we should move. Before the thing decides to follow. Could this be the town we have been seeking? I have read. It would seem so. Good day. We should find somewhere to tie our horses up. Velmir Inn. It seems as good a place as any. All right. Behave, Banner. Be sure to see to you before we go. So this is the town. Spiders. Perfect. We should take our time here while we can. Get provisions, food, water, anything else we'll need before we climb this godforsaken mountain. I'm sure the walk will not be easy. I can only hope we're in the right place. Let's see.
Welcome to the Villamere Inn. If there's anything I can get you, just let me know.
Many thanks, Villamere. Well, let us get some drink. Good day.
I think I saw it again. That ghost. It was over by the barrows.
Ghost?
That thing's evil, Linley. I told you to keep away from there.
I'm sorry. I was curious. I didn't believe the stories. I won't go over there ever again.
See that you don't. I promised to keep you safe, and I'm not going to break my word.
My lady, you spoke of a ghost.
Pardon me, my lord. Would you care to hear me play my lute?
No, it is fine. But perhaps, do you know anything of High Hrothgar?
I've always fancied a journey up the 7,000 steps to the monastery. Anything to break the boredom of living in this town. Mm. I envy you.
Well, good day.
A pleasant journey, my lord.
Thank you. Not exactly used to that. All right, we'll be fast, don't worry. Good day.
If I were you, I'd keep away from the barrow on the east side of town. It's haunted.
I think I saw this barrow. Is there anything you might be able to tell me about High Hrothgar? I plan to walk the 7,000 steps.
The Greybeards are a solitary lot. I don't think they've ever ventured outside their monastery. We get the occasional pilgrim passing through here on their way to the summit, but almost all of them have returned disappointed.
I see. This barrow you speak of. Could you tell me more about it?
There ain't much more to tell. They're haunted, and you should stay away. Look, I've seen one of the spirits with my very own eyes. When it glared at me, I swear it burned right through my soul.
Does it haunt your town as well?
Fortunately, they seem to be sticking to the barrow. I think they're guarding it. Certainly isn't helping my business any. Who'd want to rent a room anywhere near a haunted barrow?
Perhaps they are protecting it for good reason. Sometimes the dead do not deserve to be disturbed. There are reasons for these things. In that regard, I'm sorry. I cannot help you. If these spirits do... if they do move out and cause any threat to your town, I would be more than happy to deal with them. But for now, I cannot help you.
Don't blame you one bit.
I have a few bottles, if I can get those filled up. Thank you. Let's see. So I might be able to have a look and see what you have for sale.
Drink for the thirsty, food for the hungry.
Well, I'm both. Good. Soups. I'll take all the soup you can. If you could package in a bottle, I'd be most pleased. Another stew. Good. I'll take them all. Right. Many thanks. That will be all. Thank you.
If you're headed up to the monastery, watch your step. It's a long way down. Have you spoken to Fastred yet?
No. I'll tell you. If I could sweep her away from here tomorrow, I'd do it. But Klimek still has so much to learn.
Klimek is doing just fine.
If you fancy a bit of music, let me know.
Perhaps one day, but not today.
A bite to eat, Lydia, before we travel.
Lindley, would you mind taking care of me?
Let's see. Some of those soups, perhaps. Yes. I'll have one chicken for now. Perhaps one of those sweet rolls.
Customer, please?
You want a drink?
No, I'm fine. But thank you.
No problem.
Still a little hungry. I'll save the stew for now. No point in having anything else. All that venison, though. It won't last much longer. If I have the chance, I should try and cook it up. The cold for now is preserving it, at least. Lydia, it is time. Let us be on our way. And the air is fresh indeed. Where do these steps begin, I wonder? This must be the barrow. Perhaps once we return, we will see if they need aid. But the dead should be respected. Man's just standing over there. Peculiar. Alright. Banner and your beast. They should remain there. Banner's loyal. There's no way we'll be able to get them up that mountain. Not all those steps. Quaint town. Steps again,
not today. I'm just not ready to make the climb to High Hrothgar. The path isn't safe.
Aren't the Greybeards expecting some supplies?
Honestly, I'm not certain. I've yet to be allowed into the monastery. Perhaps one day.
You mentioned the supplies? Excuse me.
Hello, my friend. What can I do for you on such a fine day?
I heard you speaking of High Hrothgar. I was hoping I might be able to seal a moment of your time.
I always thought it was odd that there's a layer of thick clouds covering the peak of the mountain above the monastery. Not sure what's up there, but I bet the Greybeards know.
I'm sure they do. All right, thank you for your time.
Have yourself a great day.
Yeah, I will. He's a cheery fellow. If the Greybeards were expecting supplies, perhaps they would need some brought to them. Unfortunately, my pack is not very big. We can only carry what we have, and that's only enough food for us. I'm sure if they're expecting supplies, they'll be brought to them. No doubt. Hrothgar. The bear. Avoid them at all costs. This will be a long walk indeed. See. Before the birth of men, the dragons ruled all wonders. Their word was the voice, and they spoke only for true needs. For the voice could blot out the sky and flood the land. A poem of sorts. Interesting. All right, Lydia. Do your best. This is going to be a tiring walk indeed. Some exercise, though. I'll need to get in closer. Let's see. Nicely done. Indeed, my aid. Well done. It is a long climb ahead of us. And this road. It is not well paved. I wouldn't expect it. If others have made the climb, we will too. How unsafe can it be? Well, I don't know about you, but I haven't been counting. I know we're nowhere near 7,000 yet, though. Are you friend or foe?
Keep an eye out for wolves if you're headed up the path to High Hrothgar.
I am. Look, do you visit these Greybeards?
They're not the sort to take visitors. But I never go that high up the path anyway. Some folk who make the trip leave them food or other essentials, but not to make conversation.
I see. What are you doing up here, then?
I like to spend time up here. Walk the steps. Meditate on the emblems. Doesn't hurt when I bag some game along the way.
Of course. I did not hear it myself, but supposedly the Greybeards called for the Dovahkiin, I believe it was.
I did. Strange days when the monks will do that. I wonder what it means.
As do I. Thank you.
Good day.
And keep well. The weather appears to be turning. You should be cautious. If we're caught up here in a blizzard, we won't have many options. Let's see. Men were born and spread over the face of Mundus. The dragons presided over the crawling masses. Men were weak then and had no voice. It appears this voice is a power of sorts. Magic. Maybe. There's more than enough game up here, that's for sure. I have no need for them, though. Not now. Yeah, it's definitely colder. Gods! What is that? Shit! Frozen! Lydia! I think I got it. Well done. The thing throws me in place. I've seen their kind once before. No doubt you have as well. Reefs. Let us be moving. If there are more, I would be wary. This cold is not doing us well. We must move faster. Pull your cloak tight. Goat tracks. Damn. did not see the bastard till he was on me. Well done. He's better camouflaged to the snow. The goat did not survive. Perhaps we'll be able to return for some meat on the way down. My cloak is barely keeping me warm. The cold is almost unnatural. Perhaps it is a test, a barrier of some kind, meant to turn those back. Another emblem. Let's see. The fledgling spirits of men were strong in the old times, unafraid to war with dragons in their voices. But the dragons only shattered them down and broke their hearts. Perhaps this is more of a folktale. A spoken history of the Nords. The winds are getting stronger. If we lose sight of each other, make sure to stay within shouting distance. You do not want to get separated on this mountain. Gods. I'm glad we did not bring the horses. They would not fare well in these conditions. And we don't fare so well in these conditions. Alright. Pick up my pace while I can. I'll end up exhausted, no doubt. All I can do for now. Another one. Is that a person? It seems as though it is. Excuse me. Good day. Hello.
I.
Who are you?
Just a pilgrim. I'd prefer to leave it at that, if you don't mind.
Of course. I did not mean to intrude. Sorry. Interesting. Strange place to meditate. I suppose you Nords are used to the cold, though. Built for it better than us Imperials. That's for sure. I don't think I'd be able to get away with bare arms up here. You seem to be coping rather well. Alright. The path narrows. I see it. Watch yourself. Here it comes. Charge it down! Strike! Stun it! Well done. Good teamwork. You do not stand much of a chance against us. Fighting the thing alone would be much more dangerous. I'm glad to have you with me, Lydia. This must have been its cave. You can take a moment from the wind. Although, it's just not much of a respite. We should continue. While we can. Before we lose our strength. Another. Man prevailed, shouting Alduin out of the world, proving for all that their voice too was strong, although their sacrifices were manifold. Humanity won out. These are legends, though. Surely nothing more. A metaphor for the beginning. Although, I know those dragons are no metaphor. I've seen two now. And fought one to the death. At great cost. If these greybeards truly do know about the dragon threat, perhaps they might be able to reduce that cost. Perhaps. Another cave. Well, if we get snowed out, we might be able to retreat. With roaring tongues, the Sky Children conquered. The founding, the first empire were sword and voice, whilst dragons withdrew from this world. Alright. It is only getting worse. I'm glad I'm fully covered now. This one's rather exposed. The tongues of the Red Mountain winter were humbled. Jurgen Windcaller began his 7-year meditation to understand how strong voices could fail. All this talk of voices. That dragon spoke, shouted. It held power. How could such words have power? Jurgen Windcaller chose silence and returned. The 17 disputants could not shout him down. Jurgen Windcaller built his home on the throat of the world. Hrothgar, perhaps. Maybe. We are high indeed. High in the clouds. Lydia! We've made it. At least I hope so. If we've taken a wrong turn. No, this must be it, surely. Talos. For years, all silence, the Greybeard spoke no name. Tiber Septim, stripling then, was summoned to Hrothgar. They blessed and named him Dovahkiin. Tiber Septim was dragonborn. Dragonborn, Dovahkiin. The Septims. The voices worship followed the inner path, speak only in true need. We made it. I thank you, Lydia. Let us find fire. Ah, these are the offerings, I see. Or perhaps we might be able to leave something when we go. I'm ready to be inside.